Hi everyone, this is Nudep, and today we are going to build this fancy timer Ito tried to build in his latest LP. So, just a quick demonstration first. Okay, so if we click on the left button, the wall cycle left, okay, you can see, and if we click on the right button, the wall cycle right. Okay, so let's start. First of all, we are going to build the frame, okay, so put the piston, really simple, one towards the top, one towards the bottom, and two on the side. And next we count 12 holes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay? So, just gonna put different holes so we can see changes. Okay. I'm gonna put the orange one to try to see something. Okay, so I agree, this does not matter, but just for the sake of the clarity. Yeah. Okay. This piston, okay, so everything is pushed, nice. And then, same thing on the other side. One piston top, one piston bottom, and two on the side, okay? Up, and if we push this one, okay, nice. Blue wool. And orange. So, yeah, this is the default configuration with an hole on the miss hole on the top left and a miss one on the bottom right. Next, we are going to put the frame, and we need. Whatever block you want for the frame. I'm just gonna use the same Ito used. And a sticky piston. Yeah. To pull and push the wall. Okay. A sticky piston here. And this piston is gonna push the wall in this hole. Yeah. And retract it so the wall can cycle through and then push again. Okay, so this is the first behavior we want, and we want it for both inputs. So we are going to have two inputs, one to cycle the wall through the left. So if we click here, cycle through the left. If we click here, we cycle through the right. Okay. So first behavior, we want this piston extend by default, like this. And if we click here or here, we want this piston to retract. Simple. We're just going to put blue wool here for the circuit, and those are the two inputs. So if we click here, piston retract and then extend, same thing here. Nice. And then we want two quick pulse to activate those different piston. Okay. So for this we are going to make monostable circuits. If you don't know what a monostable circuit is, you can go to see on the wiki, everything is explained. Oh, this is not the right way. How do we do that? I want something here. Okay, a repeater is good. Maybe. Yeah. So, a monostable circuit is basically something that generates a quick pulse from any kind of input from off to on. So if I click here, oh, this is not the right one. Sorry. If I put a signal here, okay, I'm going to have a quick pulse here, just a one tick pulse on this torch. Yeah, you can see we have a longer pulse here. You can see the redstone is activated for, I don't know, 1 second, but this one is just a one tick pulse. So we can use this input to activate the different piston on the side. And we are going to do the same thing on the other side. Okay. I'm just putting blue wool to make the difference between the different circuitry. Just to try to be clear. Up, I miss it again. So yeah, 3 of delay on this repeater. So we need 3 because we need 1 tick for this one to be powered off, and 1 tick to this one to be powered on, and 1 more tick to this one to reset this one off. Okay, so I guess I made this wrong. Yeah, sorry. Okay, that's better. Okay, so same thing on both side, and if we have a quick pulse here, take something, you can see here, quick pulse. Nice! So, first part is down, and next part is hook up this signal to this piston. But first, we are going to see and try to understand what is the behavior we want. So if I click on this piston, I want the wool to cycle this way. So I want this wool to go top and this wool to go down at the same time. So we want to activate this one and this one, and then we want wool to go on the left, right, sorry, and this row to go on the left. So what we want is hook this signal to first this one and then this one. Pretty simple. I'm gonna use the orange wool to this circuit. Okay. So we want to power this piston first, just put redstone to it, okay, and then we want to power this one with a small delay. Yeah, so I can have done this this way. Okay, but I will need more space to power this one without interfering with this circuit. So just two wool here. And okay, so this piston, then this one with a small delay, so just put a delay here. Even gonna do the other side. Okay, and here we go. Those two pistons are hooked up, and the behavior we want is this one up and this one up and then on the right. Let's see. Awesome. Okay, and we want for this one, we want the wool to cycle to the left. I have trouble to find my right and my left, sorry. So to the left. So what we want to do, no, to the right. Okay, if I click on this one, I want the wool to cycle this way. If I click on this one, I want the wool to cycle this way. So what I want to do is to push this row, okay, one block to the right, and this row, one block to the left. So activate this piston first and this one at the same time. And then, to be in the same configuration, push the wool one top and this one down. Okay. So we want to push this one first and this one next. And this is basically the same circuitry with a delay on the other side. So let's see. I'm gonna use white wool. White tool. Okay. And this one. So this one first. Okay, so straight redstone and put a delay on this one. Oh, sorry. So this is exactly the same, but the delay is on the other side. Okay, nice. Yeah, you see this one has activated first and then this one. Yeah, it's not working because not everything is hooked up, but it will. So next part of the behavior, we have this one. Okay, push up and then on the right. So we want this one to push down and then on the left. So we need to hook up this signal to this piston and this piston and this one first. Pretty simple. This one first, we said, okay, up, and this one with a small delay, up, just get the rest on over there, put, yeah, we need to put a block on top here to avoid short circuit, and, okay, put redstone on the circuit. Yeah, and this functionality is done. So put the wall, wall here, wall is on the wrong side, so bottom right and top left. Mm. Okay, may have done something wrong over there. This one should okay. So why? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. This should work. Okay, so this is working. Yeah, so Jim's gonna sleep and I just saw the problem. Ah, come on, it's night. Sleep. Okay. Okay, so we have a bed switch here. This piston, this redstone powers this block and activate this piston, so we need to put this one more block on top. Yep, like this. Okay, so no more bud switch and yeah, awesome. So functionality down. Next one. Why is this working? I'm using the wrong one again. Sorry. So same thing. Okay. Yep. No more short circuit. I made a mistake here. This wasn't a bud switch, but you see the repeater activates. Wait. Okay, I did everything one block more up. No. Here. Right, let me see. Oh, this is the other side. Made the thing the other way. I guess. Oh yeah, it's no, it's one block bottom. Okay, sorry. So yeah. Repeater here, so circuit. Signal comes through, up, this one first, so just, okay, get the signal here, and this one next with a short delay, yeah, and up, default state. Yeah, awesome. So this is working. Okay, so simple signal comes here. Okay, nope, this one first, this one with a short delay. Next part, we need to hook up this piston and this one to this signal. So very simple, just so which one we want. Okay, we want this one to push this row, and then this one to push down. So this first, next one. So same thing, very simple, just get redstone signal of it, out of it, okay, and then we can even put thing here, and a short delay on this one. Yep. Okay. And just get the signal down over there. Follow the white hole, like follow the white rabbit, but with a white hole. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I guess the signal won't be strong enough. Yeah. So just let me check over there. I did exactly the same thing. Not exactly. Yeah, this is the same way. So, another reason for this thing doesn't work is because we push this row first, okay? But this piston is not retracted when this piston tries to push. So we need to induce a little delay on the circuit. And we can do this by putting just a repeater here to include a really small delay. Yeah, we can try again. Okay, wall there. Up. This way. And I guess this is working. Yeah. So I'm just gonna be there. I guess we can see everything almost. So yeah, really simple, two input, two circuit, just induce small delay when you need it, and yeah, very compact. Hope it can help, and yeah, hope you enjoy it, and see you next time. Thanks for watching.